Hey there everyone, it's Chris again. We're doing another one of the unboxing series videos today. For those of you who possibly aren't familiar with the idea of why I do these, a quick explanation. Essentially, they are a series of sort of mini reviews, I would call it. Rather than buying stuff and then taking an individual item and trying to do a whole video review just dedicated to that one product. I try and basically whenever I get a package, some stuff arrives from whichever retailer I've been buying from, I'll take it out of the box to take a quick look at each item and why I feel it's why I've decided to spend my money on it, basically why I feel it's a good thing to use to buy whatever in Airsoft. So today we're looking at this line here. Came from UN company this time. I picked it up actually a couple of days ago when I was back at work, but I thought rather than just have a background of my door in my room at the Barrett block, I'd take it back home. So I have already actually opened it to have a look at the contents, but like I say, I thought it'd be a little bit of nicer background, a little bit more pleasant to watch if I brought it home. I'll do it here. So yeah, we'll start off. There's a couple of little basic things. Some of the these are the ladder style protective rail covers made by they're sold as MAdbull at some places, but these particular ones have the ERGO, ERGO. I'm not sure if you'll ever see that. Not sure if it'll focus. Yeah. Good thing about these are actually longer than your standard, slightly longer than your standard rail cover. With your standard KAC 11 rib, it's a bit shorter than one of these. Handy thing about these as opposed to XTMs or any of the other full surrounded type covers is that they are nice and low profile, and if you've just got a bit of rail, you just want to protect it, but you're not planning on actually gripping the weapon and that part of the rail, or even if you are, but this just keeps it a lot lower profile, keeps everything slimmer. Nice and lightweight, simple to attach. Can't really go wrong. And next up, now this is where UN Co. did fall down a little bit. This is a set of anti-rotation links for WA system gas blowback M4s. Now these ones are made of 5KU, and the ones I ordered were GNP. So I've emailed UN Company about that, I shall report back later, and we'll see how they deal with that. Idea behind these, when you install on your gas blowback rifle M4 of choice, basically what they do is these two silver pins here, they replace two of the pins that go through the internals in the lower receiver, and then you've got these two sort of covers and the screws they hold these on. They basically prevent these pins, they can never move side to side as you're firing the weapon. Sometimes the pins can fall out, the standard pins. This set, replacing all the pins and putting the covers on, stops that possibility. You know, it's never going to happen with this, which is a nice little... They're not terribly expensive, it's not going to massively improve your weapon, but they look quite cool. Not a bad idea to install. Next up, this is the Daniel Defense Omega rail, a replica of it, as it were, by MAdbull. This is the 9-inch version of the M4, put on one of my M4s. Comes in two parts. The main rail section in the lower part, and these are the bag of the screws and stuff to install it. Look, nicely wrapped up as you can see, which is good. Bubble wrap. See, now, the handy thing about the Omega rail, as opposed to the wrist 2 or the light or whatever, is that you can use your standard AR-15 style barrel nut and delta ring setup. If you had a gun with standard plastic handguards, pop them right off and this goes straight on there. There's no dedicated barrel nut that you have to attach to the gun. So it's an extremely simple rail to fit. Very, very easy. Quality wise, MAdbull, I mean, they are a top end manufacturer. They make really good quality bits of kit. The machining, you know, it's very precise. It's well done. All the holes, all the edges are cut smoothly and sharply. There's no flashing or mould lines or anything like that. The finish is smooth. All the numbering and the lettering that you've got all in between the rails there, it's neat and clean. These rails that the Mavel ones, their whole range, they generally average in around $100 area. Overall, I think they're certainly worth the money. Only slight, or some people might regard this as a downside, you'll be able to see it there. There is a little bar just there inside the rail. Now, normally your gas tube would go through there, but to prevent these airsoft handguards being fitted to real weapons, they put that in. But it's fairly easy to remove with any Dremel or hacksaw or a drill or anything to get that out there if you want to put a fake gas tube on your airsoft rod. But look at the lower part. As you can see, got some nice thermal defence markings on there. All fits together. Not actually easily. That's about face, so that's probably why it's not working. Once it's installed, fits together like that. Looks pretty freaking sweet, I think. You've got this top section here, that your delta ring obviously will be sitting here, that covers that, so you've got a continuous monolithic top rail with the handguard itself joining up with the 20mm rail on the top of your upper receiver. Just really very well made. Not too heavy at all, considering that these rails tend to have a bit of a reputation for being weighted, but really not bad. Really not, just really very good looking, I must be said. And as I mentioned before, easy to install. You've also got QD sling points near the rifle end, but one on the right hand and left hand sides. If you want to put a rail on your M4, you want something nice and easy to install, and no specific AR-15 wrenches required, the Omega, something to go for. Now, next up is the main sort of guest resistance plate. Pop the order. Excuse me a minute, I'll try to set the box. This is the KC-02 gas blowback rifle from KJW. It's an airsoft replica, of course, of the Ruger 1022, which is a .22 rifle. Comes in a standard sort of cardboard box, as you can see. Nice bit of polystyrene form inside there to hold everything securely. In the box, you've got your manual, parts diagrams, various KJW sort advertising stuff. You've got a little box of BBs there, an iron sight adjusting tool, and a loading tool for the magazine. Now, I've already been inside the box to have a bit of play with this because I couldn't resist. Now, when you actually buy it, it comes wrapped in plastic. Now, that may not seem like a massive deal, but when you're dealing with gas weapons like this, you really need to keep them clean. You need to keep the mechanism lubricated. You need to stop that lubrication getting fouled with dust and dirt and oil and crap and mud from the outside. So that sort of thing really prevents any ingress of any dirt and moisture. So while that's been sitting in the box, you know it's been kept clean. It's been preserved basically while it's waiting on the on the shelf in whichever retail you purchase from. Comes with one magazine, holds 22 rounds, works with propane. As you can see, I've already taken the side rails off because I don't plan on using it. But it does come with, at the moment I've got the rail covers fitted, but the rail is there. It comes with rails on all three sides, and obviously that top one there for fitting any accessory under the sun. And it comes with the standard PAC rail covers. Rail's made of plastic, which keeps the weight down. But it's, you know, it's not cheap plastic, it's nylon reinforced, nice stuff. I'll go into a massive amount of detail on the gun now. I plan on doing a bit more of an in-depth review on this because it's quite an interesting weapon. As I mentioned, comes with one magazine, comes with these quite nice iron sights, rear and a fixed front, all the adjustments that you'd expect, windage, elevation, adjustment up front as well, and as I mentioned before, comes with the adjustment tool. You can take pretty much any retractable AR-15 stock on there, take various pistol grips, and it's just very nice to use. Magazines, a little bit fiddly to fit, but nice and small. There's no actual bolt release lever on this, which is a shame, which means I can't try fire it more than once. That's that, you can't, there's no way. Obviously if it was an M4, you could put your thumb on the bolt release and be able to keep on dry firing it, but it's that one release. But overall, considering it's a $200 gun, the quality is absolutely fantastic. It really is, it's built beautifully, considering $200 is... There's a lot of retailers out there that would ask a lot more than 200 for a lot of the really budget, low-end Chinese-made guns out there. This is, you know, KJW's M4 is pretty well known as being highly reliable, really nicely built. This thing, again, it keeps that reputation up. Really, especially considering the price, very, very impressed with it. So, yeah. Thanks for tuning in again, guys. I'll have more various different videos for you in the future. Keep on subscribing and giving a thumbs up. It's appreciated. And I'll see you next time.